Welcome to the new journey to paradise. This is part 14. My name is Michael, and I'm the founder of Triple Grace and the Righteous Path Movement Foundation. And today we will talk about the Commonwealth of God. I think you have never heard about this, and you will be surprised about the information that we will give you. But before we start, please subscribe, like the videos, click the bell icons, and share the videos with your friends and families. And also, if you would like to continue us with the videos and help with the establishing of societies of the Rose in the nations and to lift up the needy and the nameless and faceless, please do an act of loving kindness and make a donation towards our ministry. All the information you will find in the description box below. And I thank you very much for any kind of funds that you will send towards us and for any kind of support that you can bring us. Now let us start today in the part 14 with the Commonwealth of God. What is the Commonwealth of God? The Commonwealth of God is a union of all societies of the Rose. And the societies of the Rose are the assemblies of love and righteousness. And these will be worldwide to support one another and to bring forth the kingdom of God into all nations. Now, before we continue on this, I would like to share with you about the societies of the Rose. We have a whole teaching about it, a whole special video that you please watch and learn about societies of the Rose, who and what we are and what we do and who can establish them and how to do this one and how many members, and all this will be inside there. You will find it at YouTube, and to watch it will cost you nothing. So now let us have an overview about societies of the Rose, who and what we are. You see here that we have put a lighthouse there, because we see that the societies of the Rose and Triple Grace are the tower of the flock, the lighthouse that will call you in into safe havens. And all the safe havens of the Lord together will then form the Commonwealth of God. Now, have you heard about societies of the Rose, but you do not know who they are and what they do? So let us unveil who and what we are. We are the ambassadors of the heavenly kingdom, the weapons for combat of God, joint heirs with Jesus Christ. We represent the kingdom and show the heavenly culture to the nations. Each society of the Rose is filled with true sons and daughters of God, acting as the lion and lionesses of Judah, by walking as our Lord Jesus did when he was on earth, talking like him, acting like him, raising the dead, bringing forth people out of the graves, healing the sick. We might not do everything right away, but on our way towards Mount Zion, we will get these abilities. We are living true faith. We are living true faith daily by coming together, supporting one another, lifting up the needy, and spreading the love of the Father to all who will listen. We are not doing it in our own name. We are doing it in the name of the Father only. And of course, in the name of Jesus Christ. We will open the eyes of the sinners, polarize families, break nations, and tread on serpents and scorpions. We are the manifestation of the true sons and daughters of God on earth, the Joel 2 army, and the first dominion of the power of God in the world. We are clothed in fine white linen, not only spiritually, but also physically, because we have white uniforms for our special occasions. Societies of the Rose dress rehearse the coming millennium kingdom in love, unity and support for all to see. We are doing a casting call right now for people who want to become ambassadors of Christ, warriors for God, and true sons and daughters of the Heavenly Father. You can join us through TripleGrace.com. Help us to bring forth as many societies of the Rose as possible in the nations by being a patron for all ambassadors in the world here at our links that follows. Be a true ambassador of the Lord and bring in sponsors and new members to our cause. Minimum 10 sponsors and members to receive an ambassador badge on our website. Send your sponsors to these places and they to do an act of loving kindness and come together, and later they can be members of societies of the Rose. But if they do not want, they can be sponsors and help and assist in bringing the movement forward. Inform us about your good work for the Lord and the sponsors and members you are bringing into the societies of the Rose, and you can qualify for your own society in your neighborhood. We are separating the wheat from the tares. Show your commitment to the Father and be part of the societies of the Rose today. The Lord wants to use you as His weapons on earth. His Joel 2 army. This is a special teaching on it on our YouTube channel. Please watch it. As His ambassadors and His true sons and daughters. Here you see a video. This is courtesy of a prophetess, Princess Bola Adelani. It's about the unveiling, because the unveiling has taken place. Now you will see the true sons and daughters into the world. This was a short overview about Societies of the Rose and what we do. Please watch the whole video about the Societies of the Rose that you will find in our on our YouTube channel. Now, if you go back to the Commonwealth of God, you will see here that these Societies of the Rose will then be the powerhouses of the Lord on earth. We have a whole page dedicated to it, the powerhouses of the Lord. The Societies of the Rose established in all nations. Emily Rose is another prophetess on YouTube, and she had a prophetic word about the powerhouses of the Lord, what will fit so perfectly what the Lord has commanded us to do. And this video is courtesy of Emily Rose Lewis, and the channel name is also there. Please watch it, and then you will understand how we can bring all together. Gather the people together in Societies of the Rose, and then gather the Societies of the Rose together into a Commonwealth of God. So, now let us continue with the Commonwealths. All assemblies have equal rights in this union, because it will be a union of the true sons and daughters of God worldwide, from every continent, from every country, from every town. They will all come together in the Commonwealth of God. And they will benefit equally from all that is offered, from all benefits, from all support that is provided by Triple Grace. They can exchange members between one society and another, even across borders, and can transfer ideas from nation to nation for kingdom purposes, so that we, in a unity, can advance the kingdom of the Father and can bring forth a millennium kingdom where our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ will rule as a king. Triple Grace offers them a platform to connect with any other assembly worldwide and to share their experiences through a special Commonwealth forum. The member exchange is another idea from Triple Grace, solely for Commonwealth of God member assemblies. Of course, a Society of the Rose does not have to take part in the Commonwealth of God, but it would receive greatly more knowledge and more wisdom through the Spirit if it would take part. The main focus of the Commonwealth of God is to spread the gospel of the kingdom to all nations through love, unity and support. About love, unity and support, we have done a special video. Please watch it. The Commonwealth of God members are committed to Yahweh, the Father. Alone by becoming true sons and daughters, through following the great example our Lord Jesus has set for us. Not sitting quiet at home, but doing what Jesus has done. Righteous deeds every day. A daily sacrifice of love in the name of Yahweh. Because Jesus has set us a great example. We have to follow him. We have to walk as he did. They agreed to follow the principles of Triple Grace and to allow always and to always support any society of the Rose and any member thereof worldwide. They act in love, unity and support to be an example of God and the light in the darkness. Societies of the Rose will be established in Muslim countries, in countries where Hinduism or Buddhism is the main religion. It will be established anywhere where two or three people will come together in the name of the Father. Through the Commonwealth of God, the societies of the Rose worldwide have a better way to connect with one another and to show forth their individual missions for the Lord on an international field. The Commonwealth of God can act on behalf of all societies and can advance their causes with grants, financial support and expertise. The Commonwealth of God is a trumpet, the mouthpiece of even the smallest societies of the Rose and even the poorest. And even this one who is completely made out of nameless and faceless people. But the Commonwealth of God is their mouthpiece and will support all righteous activities worldwide. It can bring support and assistance to the needy without delay and can assign societies of the Rose towards any calamity that may arise in the area. The Commonwealth of God is a union of all societies of the Rose worldwide to advance the kingdom of God in love, unity and support. So if you are a member of a society of the Rose and this society of the Rose is not yet member of the Commonwealth of God, so please talk with your elders, sit together with your people and bring the societies of the Rose into the Commonwealth. You will receive so much blessing from the Father. You will receive so much knowledge and wisdom from the Holy Spirit. I know this will not be done immediately and it will not be done within a few days. But over the years we will build a very strong Commonwealth of God. It seems to be brand new for most people. But the coming together in unity is what Jesus has talked about and what the Father always wants from us. Come together in love, unity and support. Support of one another and support of the needy, the nameless and faceless. This was part 14 of the new journey to paradise. My name is Michael and I thank you that you are here with me. If the Holy Spirit will guide you and you will help us with a donation, then all the information will be in the description box below. Please click the bell icon so that you will be notified about part 15 that will come up in the next 2 days. As for today, take all the information you have received, pray over it, take it to the Lord and join us, not only at YouTube, not only at Patreon, but also at our website at triplegrace.com. So please use all the links that we provide in the description box below and have a look at what the Lord is offering to us and what we can give you in knowledge and wisdom. May God bless you and your family abundantly. My name is Michael and I will see you in the next part, in part 15. Maranatha.